One of the important questions that I'm asked is, Dr. Harness, what's the chance that my in situ breast cancer will come back after you perform a lumpectomy? Now, that's a big question, and there are lots of factors that go into the odds or the chance of a in situ breast cancer coming back. Let me try and highlight these for you right now. Things that I look at in making recommendations or predictions about recurrence include the grade of the tumor, the size of the tumor, the age of the patient, the markers that the tumor has. And let me explain a little bit. By grade, I mean we have low grade, intermediate grade, and high grade. As the grade goes up to higher grade, the chance that the cancer can come back locally certainly increases. What about size? The bigger the area of the in situ breast cancer, we worry about, again, a chance of the cancer coming back. Now, all of these recommendations are with the assumption that the surgeon performs the surgery properly and has a sufficient amount of normal breast tissue around where the in situ breast cancer was. What about the markers? The estrogen and progesterone receptor markers being positive means that we can use an anti-estrogen pill as a part of the adjuvant treatment of in situ breast cancer. And there's a very interesting research study going on if the in situ breast cancer is HER2-new positive. One of the big and most recent breakthroughs announced at the 2011 Breast Cancer San Antonio Symposium was the use of Oncotype DX as a way of trying to determine whether a patient needs adjuvant radiation therapy. And it ends up in this prospective trial that the results show that only about a third of the patients with in situ breast cancer actually need adjuvant radiation therapy. So what's the take-home message? There are a lot of factors that go into the chance of a cancer reoccurring, an in situ breast cancer coming back. Please be working with a multidisciplinary team. Please weigh all of these factors. Typically, the chance of local recurrence shouldn't be much greater than around 0.5 to 0.7% per year. But the bottom line is, please be working with a multidisciplinary team where I believe you'll get the best care. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.